Welcome guys. So now we'll see more query operators. So in last tutorials we have covered the comparison query operators, logical operators, and now we'll cover the element query operators. So we'll cover the exist and type. So again they are useful queries. So let's check out how they work. So this is the collection on which we are working. So this is a collection where we have the following fields. So mainly our focus will be on salary and merit, on which we'll work. So first is exist. So exist says that whether the field is exist or not, and give me only those result, right? So for an example, let's say you want to find out where all the field, all the objects where salary is exist, right? Because sometimes you don't want the other fields, other objects, you want only the specific where this value contains, right? So what you can do, you say salary and then exist and then you can say true, right? So and if you run the program, if you run this, so it will give you all the objects which have the salary is true, where salary exists, right? But if you give salary false, so let's say salary false, in this case it won't give you, right? It will give you all the where salary doesn't exist. So as you can see, there is no salary. So you can do it with any field. So let's say similarly with the merit, run program. So because it is false, that is why it is not giving me any. But let's say if you give it true, so it will give you all the objects which have the merit values, right? So this was about the exist. Now we'll cover the type, right? So type means it says like sometime a field can have different types. So for example, if you say here the zip code, so let me remove that one. So the zip code is basically, so here it is the string, here it has a value, here it has a number, and here it has a number int, and here it was number double. So this field has a different values. So let me show you by this way. Okay, let me show you like this. Alright. So here the zip code is a string and here the zip code is number. Here the zip code is number long and here zip code is again a number, right? So in these cases it has different values, zip code has different types. So we want to find the type where it has a string or which it has certain type. So we can do by using the type operator. So how you can do, so first write that which element you want to see. So let's say I want to zip code, then again you write type. So type is let's say I want to search string and you run the query. So if you give zip code is type string and you run the program, so it will give you zip code which has a string type, right? So that is how you can figure out and you can work on the type when you want the specific data type, right? So for this tutorial, this is enough. We have covered the exist, where you can find that whether the field exists or not, and then give the values, and then you can find the type, that whether this particular type exists, and give me that result. So that's it for this tutorial, and in next tutorial we'll cover the evaluation query operators, which is mod, rejects, text and where, right? So thanks for watching the video and please subscribe the channel for more such videos. Thank you.